vacuum workout. Let's change the way that we view vacuuming. So many people come into my office hurting themselves vacuuming, or at least complaining that they have to vacuum again, right? Well, why not make vacuuming a workout? That's what we're gonna do here. We're gonna follow the rules. We're gonna protect our lower back. We're going to get in a workout and we're gonna make it strength training, okay? Couple of the rules are, as I show you the different things, we're gonna keep our core contracted. I call it a core brace or an ab brace. So when we're doing the different moves, keep a little core contraction. That's number one. Number two is none of this. This is what people do, which we run into problems. We're always hinging here, right? So we're gonna stay away from that. Anytime you need to pick over and pick up the vacuum, you're not bending down like this, you're getting into the squat and picking it up and so forth, okay? Now at home, if you want to, turn on some music. I've got several of my patients that will actually crank up music that they like and they start dancing while they're using the vacuum. So let's get into it. The first one is, of course, a squat. So instead of, again, bending like this, get into a squat position and get into a squat like so. Hold the squat, vacuum off to the side. Vacuum here, vacuum here. I need to move. Step, move, squat. Okay, I'm already feeling the burn. Okay, notice again, I'm keeping a nice tall body like this, and I'm getting my squat workout. It's all leg work, not back work. That's the squat. Okay, then you can transition into number two, move into a lunge. So if you're tired of doing a squat, then do a lunge. Hold the lunge, move it around, change hands. Right, now you're doing a lunge. Here's another lunge. Over here, I'm coming in the corner and I'm cleaning the studio at the same time, right? Doing a lunge, right? Move over here, another lunge. Stay in that lunge position for a while, move it around, come out of the lunge, okay? Then you can get fancier. Number three is the fencer, the fencer. Do some fencing. Move, and a fencer, just like a fencer would do, right? Switch to the other side. Come over here like this, and do the fencer. And move your legs. Notice I'm moving the legs, and I can move back and continue vacuuming around like this. Okay, that's the fencer. I'm staying low, working my quads, keeping my body straight, keeping it up here, keeping my lower back straight, coming into a position like so. Okay, so that's the fencer. Moving like so, okay? Then of course you can do a basic one. This is the fourth one. You can do a basic one. I call it the Frankenstein. The Frankenstein is tight core, nice upright body, gotta go down the hallway. This is the Frankenstein, okay? Tight core, straight back. I'm doing the Frankenstein. Switch the hands, okay? Again, you're not doing this, all right? Keep up nice and tall, a little bit of core work in here, you're doing the Frankenstein. So these first four, the squat and the lunge and the fencer and the Frankenstein, are all covering bigger areas, but everybody always asks me, what do you do when you're in a tight quarters? I can't do the squat, I've got something over here, I can't do a lunge, there's not enough space. Do a plie. So you're like this, just do this. So you do a plie, right? And here we are. You can sink down, keep the back straight, work your core, and you're moving that far away. What's the option? You would always do this, right? You would bend from the waist, and then you come back into me. You're gonna need me in my chiropractic office, right? Do a plie. Do another plie over here. Do one over here. And you can move it around like this. So now you're going up and down. You're getting that leg workout, right? You get the music playing if you want to. So you do a plie like so. Here's another one, you learned this on a prior show with me, is you do a hip hinge. So again, you don't have enough room for a squat, you don't have enough room for a lunge, so you do a hip hinge. Look at the difference. Okay, now I'm doing a hip hinge like this, right? Instead of bending over like that, or what, again, most of us do this, hip hinge, that's number six. Doing a hip hinge, okay? That gives you a lot of options of protecting your back, working your rear end muscles, working your legs, working the core. I'm still holding that core tight like this. You don't even need sit-ups and ab work. You just tighten that core. So that would give you a variety of things. Now, if you like music, of course, you can do the Beyonce and the Taylor Swift if you want to. Well, I'm going to do the Gene Kelly. All right? So, singing in the rain. You can just play music and sing to yourself, right? Why not? But follow the rules, keep that core tight, and tighten up and move around like this. That's the idea. Keep the back straight, core tight, use your legs, whether it's a squat like this and moving around, or a plie like this, or a hip hinge, whatever it is. Keep the back straight, keep the core tight, and do it. I'm Dr. Scott Fuller. Please join me again. Yeah, that's good. Good leg workout here.